Hey everyone, I'm Oris here. Today we are going to see some Windows 98 action on real hardware, but also using PCM, where it turns out that using a slower CPU can actually lead to better performance. Honestly, I never thought I would be saying something like that, but here we are. Alright, let's say you want to run Windows 98, 95 or any other classic OS on your modern desktop. Do you install it on a virtual machine like PCM, for example, or maybe you are a hardware enthusiast and you use a dedicated SSD to run everything directly on real hardware? If you've been following me, you know I'm all about using real hardware, but today we are going to see some PCM action as well, using the fastest CPU we can emulate on a Ryzen 9 3900X and a Voodoo 3 as a soft GPU. And since I have a real Voodoo 3 running on the same Ryzen 9 configuration, we can restart to see what's the difference. First of all, the Windows ecosystem is incredibly backward compatible, and here is an interesting example. This is an early 32-bit version of Doom for Windows released in April 1995, before even Windows 95 was officially launched. Back then, with the help of Win32s, we could run this game on Windows 3.11, and guess what? The very same game with absolutely no changes at all works perfectly fine on Windows 11. Obviously, not all Windows games are that forward compatible, and this is where emulators like PCM are filling the gap. But does a virtual setup really compare to the raw experience on actual hardware? While PCM, short for PC Emulator, replicates real hardware configurations down to the motherboard BIOS, which gives a genuine vintage feel. But here's where it gets tricky. PCM can emulate a CPU like a Pentium MMX or a Pentium 2 using only a single thread, while a CPU with 12 cores and 64 megabytes of L3 cache like this Ryzen 9 3900X may seem powerful enough, the performance of our emulated PC ultimately depends on single core performance. So how does this 5-year-old Ryzen 9 CPU compare in single core performance to something much newer? According to this Cinebench benchmarks, our Ryzen 3900X barely makes the list, appearing near the bottom out of 150 CPUs. In comparison, the latest generation CPUs offer almost double the single-core performance, thanks to both higher clock speeds and improved instruction efficiency. So what happens if our CPU is not powerful enough? Well, for a solid experience, the emulation speed must stay at 100%. Otherwise, every time the CPU is not emulated at full speed, a glitch in the matrix may occur.
What did you just say?
Nothing.
Let's say we want to play Quake 2 in PCM. At launch, the recommended CPU for Quake 2 was a Pentium 133 MHz. But we want to boost our specs and emulate a Pentium 2 400 instead. What could go wrong? Turns out our Ryzen 9 3900X is not up to the task. The emulation speed drops below 60%, putting everything in slow motion. Luckily, we can adjust the CPU speed on the fly, and switching to a Pentium 2, 233 MHz boosts the emulation speed above 90%, making the gameplay much smoother, though still not perfect. Finally, if we change our configuration and pick a Pentium 200 MMX, we get a steady 100% emulation speed, exactly what we need for a smoother gameplay. Now let's restart and see how it feels with an actual Voodoo 3 card paired with what the Windows 98 thinks is a crazy fast Pentium MMX running at 3.8 GHz. When benchmarked against the top CPUs of 1999, it's clear that this Ryzen 9 is playing in a completely different league. However, in Quake 2, you're getting around 80 FPS at 1024 by 768, which is typical for a Voodoo 3 card. So even with an ultra-fast CPU, our frame rate won't go crazy, since the GPU is the limiting factor here and not the CPU. Still, the gameplay is smooth and glitch-free, and the image quality is better. Now, if we really want to push some insane FPS in Quake 2 on Windows 98, we can swap in a 7900GS PCIe card or something even better. But with this exact card, we render the entire demo in just 0.7 seconds at a staggering 950 frames per second. Yes, you heard that right. 958 frames per second. Now let's switch back to our PCM setup and run Unreal. Interestingly, the game renders internally at a decent frame rate, but the on-screen result isn't quite as smooth, since the emulation speed is dropping under 100% if we go with a Pentium 2 CPU, even the slowest one. If we pick a slower Pentium 200 MMX CPU, we get a much smoother experience, but the frame rate is not great. By the way, the Voodoo 3 is emulated on 4 threads, but this is not helping when the show is run by a slower CPU. Finally, when running the same level on real hardware, the frame rate remains consistent and our actual Voodoo 3 can deliver over 60 FPS at 1024 by 768. Once again, if we are aiming for extreme FPS, we'll need a high bandwidth PCI Express card to see some big numbers. And this is how Unreal renders at 800 FPS using the same NVIDIA 7900GS. So far, we have seen that PCM can closely replicate actual hardware, which is insane given the level of complexity that is actually involved. Emulating even a Pentium 2, however, requires a very high end PC with a solid single core performance. That said, a Pentium 2 isn't ideal for a true Windows 98 gaming experience. I mean, by the early 2000s, it was already an underpowered CPU for many games, especially when Windows 98 wasn't immediately abandoned in favor of Windows XP. If you ask me, I was still running Windows 98 on my PC as late as 2004, in a dual boot with Windows XP, to be fair. By the way, I remember playing a Painkiller on Windows 98, and this is how a Painkiller looks now with all settings maxed out on my current Windows 98 setup. It's something else compared to how it looked on my GeForce 4MX GPU. What can I say? Cranking everything up to the maximum settings might be the perfect excuse to revisit these classic titles. While most late-era Windows 98 games can run on Windows 10 or 11, I prefer the nostalgic look and feel of Windows 98 whenever is possible. For instance, playing the original release of Half-Life 2 on Windows 98 feels far more captivating to me than launching it on Windows 11. Amazingly, this game still looks incredible, even when using technology from 20 years ago. Okay, maybe 18 years, because the last DirectX 9 for Windows 98 was released in December 2006. Another advantage of a very fast CPU is the ability to rely on software rendering when certain games aren't compatible with our 3D configuration. Motorhead is one of those games. At least in the version I have, it refuses to start with 3D rendering, whether on real hardware or in PCM. However, on real hardware, a powerful CPU will let us select the maximum resolution, something that wasn't feasible back in the day. Even the fastest CPUs of the time struggled with software rendering, and going higher than 640 by 480 was often more like the slideshow version of the game. That said, this game has an impressive software rendering engine, and As you can see, it's crazy fast on my setup. I could easily forget about 3D rendering. Now let's wrap things up with a DOS session where PCM shines when it comes to DOS gaming, because when using emulated cards like a Creative Sound Blaster 16, we can be sure that nearly every DOS game can be played with full sound, whether we launch it directly from DOS or from Windows. And I remember for sure that I played most, if not every, of my DOS games from Windows. On real hardware, the story is a bit different. Getting sound in DOS games requires running them through Windows only, and this is possible only if our PCI sound card has a good driver capable of emulating a sound blaster without any hardware support, as native ISA support in chipsets disappeared in the early 2000s. So depending on what card and drivers we use, we still can get sound in those games while using a very modern setup, but keep in mind that many of those games won't play nice about our sound setup, while some select those games won't run in Windows. Even so, getting sound in those games is sometimes easier than you might think. Here's a short clip from one of my earlier videos showing how not complicated it can be with the right hardware.
Now let me show you one thing that I like about Windows Millennium. Is that the fact we do have a DOS sound in Windows without any extra settings. It works right out of the box. MIDI, device detected, audio, device detected, done. Now let's check this game.
In the end, I think real hardware offers a more authentic experience and significantly better performance for demanding games that can't run in a virtual machine. While PCM is free, setting up a real hardware PC, modern PC for Windows 9X, does require some investment. You need a compatible sound card, possibly a USB adapter and a GPU. However, as long as you stay away of cult hardware like 3DFX Voodoo cards, most PCI sound cards and early PCIe GPUs such as GeForce 6 or 7 series remain quite affordable. It's also worth noting that running Windows 98 on real hardware is often more energy efficient. For instance, a PCI card like the Voodoo 3 I used in this video draws only about 15 watts, which is likely less than the power consumed by a high-end PC running PCM with four CPU threads dedicated for the soft GPU. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, some very exciting videos are just around the corner.